Now, I'd like to just share a few thoughts with you quickly about the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant is the earthly throne of God. The reason that God told Moses to build a sanctuary was for the purpose that God could dwell among his people. So he made the statement to Moses, he says, build me a sanctuary that I may dwell among you. So that was the entire purpose, and of course the Ark of the Covenant in that sanctuary was a copy of the heavenly throne of God. We need to have that firmly fixed in our mind because it becomes important when we're considering what's about to happen next. Now, the Bible in the Old Testament predicts everything of importance. Okay? Amos 3:7, surely the Lord God will do nothing except he reveal his secrets through his servants, the prophets. The most important thing that has ever happened on this earth, the heart and soul of the plan of salvation, is the fact that Christ died, that we might have eternal life, that we might be rescued from a sentence of certain death. And the proof of that is his blood on the earthly throne of God. So we can expect that that would be predicted in the Old Testament, can't we? All right. Of course, the Bible tells us that all of the blood sacrifice system was types and shadows leading us to Christ. So they are prophetic activities that everyone that participated in were supposed to know what they meant. But like many people today, the Bible talks about having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, or being totally unfamiliar with what it all has to do about. And I'm sure there were people that participated in these blood sacrifices that lost sight of what they meant. But anyway, there is a specific prophecy, and that's found in Daniel chapter 9, verse 24.
70 weeks are determined upon thy people and upon thy holy city to finish the transgression and to make an end of sins and to make reconciliation for iniquity and to bring in everlasting righteousness and to seal up the vision and prophecy and to anoint the most holy.
Now, the Bible refers to the mercy seat on the Ark of the Covenant as being the most holy. And the reason the most holy place was called that was because this mercy seat was there. Now next, we find in the New Testament where these prophecies have been fulfilled. Are there statements in the New Testament that tell us the blood of Jesus actually went on the mercy seat? Now the next verse is quite important. It says there are three that bear witness in earth: the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three agree in one. A witness is somebody that has information or claims to have information. And what they say becomes testimony. That is their testimony. In a trial, it becomes evidence or proof. Okay? So what this verse is saying to us, when we translate it into present day English, is that God the Father is the witness and his proof to us that his Son died for us is the dried blood and serum of his Son on the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant. So God has everything on a time schedule, friends. And when the time is right, when the fullness of the time has come, then the tables of stone that God wrote his law upon to, and the same law that he spoke from the mountaintop, amid smoke and fire and earthquakes and all of that, will be presented once again to this world. And everyone will be allowed to see it, especially everyone that is interested in what's right and what's wrong in doing the will of God. At that time, the blood of Christ on the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant will be shown to the world. That will be shown on video. Tables of stone you'll be able to see for yourself if you wish. Blood of his Son on the mercy seat at the Ark of the Covenant. Now the mechanics of that, how it happened, is in Matthew chapter 27 verses 50 through 53. It says, when he had cried again, he died. The earth shook, the rocks were rent. Well, it says the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to bottom. Then the earth shook and the rocks were rent and the graves were opened. When the rocks rent, the cliff behind where Christ was being crucified split all the way down, right past the left side of the cross hole and down into the chamber where God had hidden the Ark of the Covenant some 600 years before. And when the centurion pierced Christ's spleen, and probably the left ventricle of the heart, depending on how deep the thrust went, the blood and the platelets and serum gushed out and went down through that crack onto the Ark of the Covenant 20 feet below and fulfilled, ratified, if you please, the old and the new covenant. And at that moment, you and I were bought with a price. as was everyone else on this planet. Okay, any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
My question is, are you going by sight? Did you think it was the actual blood? I mean, that it was blood, or was there testing done to make sure that this was blood?
We tested it to make sure it was blood. Yes, ma'am. And it's unique blood. When we share, well, I'll quickly state this. I know there's some doctors here and nurses and some anesthetists, people that are familiar with blood. All of us have 46 chromosomes unless we have Down's syndrome, okay? Christ had 24. Each parent supplies 23 chromosomes to a new infant, all right? Christ got 23 from his mother. He got one from his father. There was a Y, which determined that made him a male. He got it from not from an earthly father, or he would have had 46 like the rest of us. Okay? Pardon?
What cell?
White blood cells. And you're saying, how can you test a dead white blood cell for chromosome count?
That's it.
Right. His blood is not dead.